So students, in this video we'll be discussing about the various types of frictions. So to start with, we'll write down the types of frictions. Basically, in your 11th standard you'll be probably dealing with mostly 99% case static friction or kinetic friction, but still we will know about static friction, kinetic friction, then rolling friction and fluid friction. Okay, because in fluid the friction is called fluid friction. So there are four types of frictions. One is static friction, the second one is kinetic friction, the third one is rolling friction, and the last but not the least, the fourth one is fluid friction. Fluid friction. So there are basically four types of friction. So we'll start one by one. We'll start with the static friction. I'll just tell you, I'll give you a brief idea about all these frictions. Static friction is when two bodies, one body is suppose resting on the surface of another body. Okay, just like this is one body is resting on this surface. I apply a force. When a force is applied, the body will tend to move in this direction, like this. Okay, if I apply a force in this direction, this body will move in this direction, like this. Okay, so what happens is the body always moves in the direction of the applied force, net applied force. Now, if I apply a force, it may happen that I apply a force, but the body will not move. It's possible that I apply a force and it will not move. Just like you can see here, I'm applying a force, but it is not moving. I keep on increasing the force, still it is not moving, but a time will come, if I keep on increasing the applied force, time will come, it just starts moving. That means before it starts moving, I applied the force. However insignificant that force may be, however small that force may be, but when I applied the force, the object should move, but it is not moving. Then what prevents the object from moving? That we will discuss in detail. But then as long as there exists applied force, the applied force is there and the object is not moving, so during that condition, that means as long as the object is in static condition, the friction that acts is known as static friction. So static friction is the friction that acts between two bodies whenever there is a relative motion. When there is a tendency of relative motion, the relative motion has not occurred, there is a tendency of relative motion, during that time the friction will act. In simple, static friction will act between two bodies when there is a tendency of relative motion, but there is no actual relative motion. So we can write that static friction acts when bodies are at rest. Okay, there is a tendency of relative motion, but then bodies are at rest. Kinetic friction acts during motion, when one body is moving relative to another on its surface, when it's already in motion, then during motion the friction that acts is kinetic friction. So when bodies are in motion, when bodies are in motion, this friction acts. So starting friction is basically when one's body slides over another, and when it starts sliding, then friction, kinetic friction will come into picture. Rolling friction will come into play when one body is rolling over the surface of another body. When one body rolls over the surface of another body, during that time, rolling friction acts. This is due to rolling motion of body. Okay, fluid friction, when any object moves through fluid. Fluid is a common name for liquid and gas. So it's a common name for liquid and gas. It's a common name. So when a body moves through liquid or moves through gas, then the medium, whether it is gas medium, gaseous medium in which the object is moving, or it is the liquid through which the object is moving, the friction will act. The medium will oppose the movement of the object through the medium. Important point to note is this fluid friction depends on the velocity of the object that is moving through the fluid. It depends on the velocity. Greater the velocity, greater the fluid friction. But rolling friction and kinetic friction and static frictions, they are not dependent on the velocity. Okay, so there is one important point we must note out. Note down that the fluid friction, it depends on velocity, whereas others, they don't depend on, they're independent of velocity. So fluid friction is because of motion of body through fluid. Right. What are the points you have to note? So we'll note down few things, then we'll move to next video. One point is, important point to note, that fluid friction depends on velocity of body. That means more the velocity, more is the fluid friction. Second, other two or three, kinetic or rolling. Kinetic or rolling friction is independent of velocity of body. So afterwards, after a few videos, we'll see that when a body is dropped through a liquid, as the speed increases, when it falls through the gravity, the speed will increase, and as the speed increases, the force, that is the frictional force, will also increase. Okay, thank you.